going to show you a dish that looks complicated can be so easy to make at home. So let's start. First, we are going to make the carrot puree. For that, we will need 3 carrots. Cut the carrot in half and then continue cutting in smaller pieces. This will help us to cook it faster. On a medium heat pan, add 1 tablespoon of olive oil and slightly saute the carrots. We don't want color on them, just to soak them a little bit. Next, add 100 ml of orange juice and let it reduce by 80%. Once the orange juice is reduced, add water and bring to boil. Make sure the water covers the carrot and let it boil until the carrots are fully cooked. We want them to be very, very soft. Add the carrots to a food processor and add some of the remaining liquid from the pan, but not all. We can always add more while we blend it, but we can't remove. So start with a little and if needed, we add more later. Add 100 g of cold butter and process. We want a smooth consistency. If needed, add more liquid and before you remove it from the food processor, add salt and pepper. And that's the consistency we want. Now it's time for the carrot chips. With a peeler or a mandoline, make some thin slices from a carrot. Next, on a medium heat pan, add some neutral oil and bring it 140 degrees or 284 Fahrenheit and fry the carrot slices. Make sure you keep the temperature of the oil stable so the carrots won't burn. When the carrots stop bubbling, then they are ready, so remove from the oil and transfer them on a plate with some kitchen paper and let them to crisp up. Now it's time for the broccoli. Add some water in a pot and some salt and bring it to boil. Throw in your broccoli and blanch for 2 to 3 minutes. Remove and cool down in ice water and reheat before plating or use them straight away. Now let's make the marination for the chicken. So in a bowl add 1/2 tablespoon of salt, 1/2 tablespoon of garlic powder, 1/2 tablespoon of paprika powder, 1/4 teaspoon of black pepper and 1/2 tablespoon of onion powder. Mix to combine and let's season our chicken breast. Season both sides of the breast and let's cook them. On a medium heat pan, add 1 tablespoon of olive oil, let it get hot and add the chicken with the skin side down. Let it saute for 2 to 3 minutes, flip it and saute for another 2 to 3 minutes. Add some thyme and a clove of garlic into the pan, flip once more the chicken breast and cover with a lid, and cook for another 8 to 10 minutes, depends the size of the chicken breast. Once ready, remove the chicken breast from the pan and let's make the sauce. Deglaze the pan with a white wine, scrape the bottom cause there is all the flavor and let it reduce down by 80 to 90%. Once the white wine is reduced, add some chicken stock and reduce again 80 to 90% or until you have something like that. Final step, add a tablespoon of cold butter and stir until the butter fully emulsifies and thickens the sauce. Once you are ready, you can pass the sauce through a fine sieve. Before we plate, let's cut our chicken breast. Start by trimming the side of the breast so we can make it more presentable. Don't think to throw the trims. Those are for the chef, so feel free to eat them. Trim both sides and cut it in the center. Look how juicy and perfectly cooked is on the inside. Now, let's plate. Add a tablespoon of carrot puree in the plate and with a small spatula, push the puree in the back. Add your chicken breast around the puree. You can always feel free and play around. Next, add some broccoli around the plate and some leaves around the broccoli. With a squeeze bottle, make some dots around the plate and add the carrot chips as well. And last, finish with a sauce and enjoy this beautiful plate. Thanks for watching, and if you enjoyed the video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. See you on the next one.